So the last step of the categorization process is to label the classes that you have. So, and those labels will be the categories or will be teams, right? Depending on the number of classes that you have. So as you can see here, we have four classes. So our goal here is to label those clusters. So the first research question, you're going to do the sorting and then label the classes, and then you come up with the themes and they use the theme to address the research question for the first one, and you do the same thing for the second research question. So depending on the number of research questions that you have, you're going to repeat this process, right? So this will be the final outcome of the categorization process, right? So as you can see, we have classes here, and then based on the information under the cluster, or the codes under each of the cluster, we come up with the themes or the label for the clusters. So the label should be playing two roles, right? So the first role, the label is representing the cluster members, right? At the same time, addressing the research question that you have. So always have to think about the research question when you are constructing the clusters, right? Or when you are labeling the clusters. So let me do a short demonstration on how to label your clusters. So as you can see here, we have our four clusters and then the membership here. So we have to label clusters. So how do you label the cluster? You just have to look at the content or the codes under the cluster. So you can see that under this one, we have having numerous work-related tasks. We have having long hours, having trouble carrying out duties, and taking care of multiple patients. So looking at it, I think if having numerous workload can capture all the information here, and also at the same time we'll address the research question that you have, which is the causes of burnout. So we can put here having high workload. And then in parentheses, you just add the number of code count, 7 code count. Right. So now we have a label for the first cluster. So you have to make sure, as I said, you have to make sure that the label is addressing the research question at the same time representing the cluster members. Another thing that you have to think about is that you may not get a perfect label for your cluster. But you shouldn't worry so much about it, because you know what you're going to do when you are presenting your findings? You have to define or present what the theme or the cluster mean, right? Or what the cluster represents. So although it might not be a perfect label, describing what the cluster represents will help your audience to know what the themes or the labels mean, right? So as I said, it's not going to be perfect. You just have to do your best and come up with a phrase that best represents the information that you have here, and the phrase should be in between 2 to 5 words. So looking at this one, I think being new to the profession could best represent these two quotes. Here to unrealistic expectation from patients, and the last one is working harder than counterparts. And this one is like you are putting extra effort. So putting extra effort could be the best label to represent these two codes at the same time addressing the research question that you have. So that's how you're gonna do it. And then at the end of the day, those labels here will be called themes, right? Addressing the research question that you have. So we have four themes addressing the first research question, which is the causes of burnout. And then, as I say, we're going to do the same thing for the second research question, the same process, right? Hope this was helpful. If you have any question, please email me. I'll be happy to address them for you. So this is my contact information. You can also follow me on Twitter and also LinkedIn. My LinkedIn information is there. You can check our website. There are a lot of resources there, and also my book, Step-by-Step Guide to Qualitative Coding, will be the best. And if you are doing a phenomenological study, the second book will be also helpful for you. So this is what I have for you. Thank you for your time.